Every time you buy something online, it goes through a process to land on your doorstep. The process involves trucks, people, measurements, and multiple types of robots. There's a ton of math every time you click buy. Come behind the scenes with me at a distribution center to show how it's math.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
When you order something online, how does it arrive at your house? This is a warehouse. So much happens in a warehouse to make sure the product you ordered safely arrives at your doorstep. It all starts when a truck drops off products to the warehouse. They come in large boxes or pallets like this. Math is involved in figuring out how much is in each box, how many boxes fit into one truck, and how many boxes fit on one pallet. This robot here measures the interior of the truck and unloads all of the boxes. How cool is that? Once the pallet is loaded, the items will go into this section of the warehouse. This section stores the items until they are needed to send to the customers. This warehouse had to do a lot of math to make sure they had enough storage space.
My name's Meredith Williams, and I work for DHL Supply Chain in our solutions design department. My team works to design warehouses like this, and that is everything from determining how big this warehouse needs to be to how much product goes in. So when we figure out how big it needs to be, we look at the length of the facility, the width and the height, to then determine the size, as well as what we can fit in that facility. So we really take measurements seriously. It needs to be exact to ensure that we have the right numbers.
My name is Sean Leedy. I'm Senior Customer Success Manager here at Locus Robotics. Our Locus bots help companies like DHL pick items faster and more efficiently. So this is a Locus bot. Down here you'll find we have different LiDARs and cameras. This is how the bot navigates and can identify where it's going. We have safety measures on the bots that'll prevent it from colliding with people. And then we have the iPad here. This is what the pickers will use on the floor. That tells them exactly where they need to pick from.
A picker is simply a person that picks out the item you ordered and places it on the robot to be packaged to be sent to your house.
There are a number of different shelf arrays based off of how we're picking the product. We want to optimize the number of boxes we can fit on a robot. So typically we look at how many items are in an order and if it needs a large box like that, or if it needs a small box for that order. If we need small boxes, we then determine that we can fit, say, 8 small boxes, 4 and 4, or if it needs a large box, we can fit 2 large boxes, 1 and 1.
How do you figure out how many people you need to pick?
We look at what people like you are placing in terms of the quantity, the type, the product. For example, in 1 hour, we would need 800 hats. Say a person can pick 100 hats, but we need 800. You take 800 divided by 100, and that's 8 people that we would need to pick those hats.
When the product is ready to be picked and sent to the customer, it will go to this section. This section is really neat because it uses both human workers and robots to ensure you are getting the exact thing you ordered in your box. So let's go back to that fancy hat you ordered. That order will come to the warehouse, and a robot will drive up to a specific location where your hat is stored. A worker will then scan the hat and check it's the correct item, then put it in the bin. The robot will then drive to the next section of the warehouse. As you can see, there are also arrays involved in this section. Check this out. This is an example of a real-life array. How many rows and columns does this area have? Not only are arrays used, but large numbers are also used in this section. Check out how many orders they have filled. Wait a minute, do the robots have to use math?
Our data, our dashboards will provide information to the site team, and we have dashboards on the floor that will actually show where the bots are located. It's a map, it's a real-time map that will show the bots navigating the aisles, where they're located. There's graphs, you'll see percentages. We have dozens of different ways to view numbers based on what she needs. Well, you can see a total order count on a day-to-day basis. We can see how productive the bots are in terms of how many items each bot is picking on an hourly basis. We also use, for example, fractions with the bots. Bots have battery life. So our dashboards will display if the bot is beginning to die, the battery life, and say it could be down to 1/4, which we consider a critical battery life. And from there, the locust bot will then go to auto charge. The bot will automatically go to charge and then return to working once the battery is at an appropriate level.
How do we figure out how many robots we need?
Our solutions design team will initially deploy a specific number of bots based on the numbers, the volume that we're provided. And we'll have a specific bot to worker ratio, a bot to picker ratio, that we'll use to then assign what our recommendation is in terms of how many bots the site could use.
Why is it important to show your thinking?
The importance of showing your work when it comes to working in a warehouse environment with robots is that if we don't have enough bots on site, it can create problems with fulfilling orders, getting orders out on time and delivered on time. So it's important to ensure that we're double checking our work when it comes to numbers that we're reviewing.
Once your hat has been picked up by the robot, it will then go on to a section called the pack station, where they double check your order, place it in the shipping box with your address, and send it on its way. They will have to know what size box will be required to get the product to your house safely. When your box is ready to go, it goes on a conveyor belt to then another robot, which sorts the box onto a pallet to be shipped. From there, the boxes will be picked up from the warehouse to be distributed and sent to your house. Who knew so much math went into clicking add to cart? The warehouse needs to know how many robots they will need during a busy buying season. They typically need 3 robots per each picker at the warehouse. They have 18 pickers. How many robots will they need? Four robots. 18 pickers times 3 robots equals 54 robots. Did you get it correct?
DHL truly is an essential part of everyday life. A majority of the products that you have in your home may have come from a DHL site. We ship cosmetics, healthcare, medical devices, apparel.
I am Sean Leedy, Senior Customer Success Manager here at Locust Robotics, and this is math. So this is how it's math. All right. I'm Sean Leedy, Senior Customer Success Manager at Locust Robotics.
I am Meredith Williams, Senior Director of Solutions Design with DHL Supply Chain.
And this is how it's math.
Want more information about how math is used in the real world? Make sure you check out our website, www.doodleslearning.com. Bye.